I'm Aaron Gold for Auto Vitel here in Crested Butte, Colorado. Bit of a misunderstanding. I was told it was a Mazda event. I sort of didn't read the whole email, thought we were going to be driving MX-5s. Turns out it's a winter driving event for the new i-ACTIV all-wheel drive system in the Mazda CX-3 and CX-5. So today we're going to be learning about what makes the i-ACTIV all-wheel drive system superior to the systems in other SUVs, talking to some experts, and I'm going to go borrow a coat. Guys, my toes are tingling. Is that bad? Now, there's a common misperception, or at least I think there's a common misperception, that all all-wheel drive systems are created equal, and they're not. Now, there's a couple of ways to do all-wheel drive. The easy way is you can just send power to all four wheels all the time, but that's wasteful. It's not very fuel efficient. It's kind of bulky. It's not very good for today's environment. Or you could do an on-demand system, which is what most systems are. When you start to lose grip at one set of wheels, usually the fronts, then you send power to the back. The problem with this system, a system like this, is that they are reactive. Okay? By the time you're redirecting grip to the back wheels, you've already got a problem at the front wheels. Mazda wanted to make a system that was predictive, and they said, listen, we've got all this data that we can use, okay? For example, every car tells you what temperature it is right on the dashboard, so we know if it's cold and there's a good chance for snow. Hey, we can look at whether the driver has the wipers on. That means it's raining and they're gonna need a little extra grip. They can look at all these things and they can make some predictions about whether the driver might be driving their car in a situation where they're going to need all-wheel drive.
I'm Dave Coleman, and I'm a vehicle development engineer at Mazda. What makes it unique is that the system is using all of the sensors that are already in the car. It's about 27 different channels of data coming into the all-wheel drive system, and it's using that to figure out exactly what kind of surface it's driving over and what it should do with that information. So if you're on something, on a slippery hill, for example, trying to turn, a lot of these on-demand all-wheel drive systems, if you're turning, they will disconnect the rear wheels so that they don't bind up going around a corner. And since we know we're on snow, we know our tires will slip on the snow. We don't have to worry about binding up in a corner. What makes it uniquely Mazda is the effort we put into making the car drive completely intuitively all the time. We've got a phrase we call a jinbai itai. It's a Japanese saying about kind of oneness between horse and rider. It's just the concept of making the car drive completely intuitively as if it's an extension of your body. And the way the all-wheel drive system plays into that is we are sort of extending the envelope of surfaces you can drive on and still have that really intuitive, direct, connected feeling. You will never notice the all-wheel drive system working at all. It's completely seamless. There's no buttons to push. There's no flashing lights. It just finds the right torque split in any condition and gives you the really consistent performance. I think the most remarkable thing about the i-ACTIV all-wheel drive is that mechanically, it's very similar to everybody else's on-demand all-wheel drive system. And in terms of sensors and electronics and data that we had to put into the car, all of that was already there. We're using data from the steering system, we're using data from the brake system, we're using data from the stability control system. We're simply taking what we already had and making it work better. And that is another really Mazda thing to do. We take conventional technologies and push them to real extremes of performance. All of our engineering teams will sort of set a goal for what they want to do. And the way we tend to operate is we will set the most idealistic, optimistic, pie-in-the-sky kind of goal. We'll take two or three steps to get there because you can't get to this completely ideal state in one shot. But the reason there is some potential to be able to make an all-wheel drive car more efficient than a two-wheel drive car is that there's actually a lot of energy lost in slipping the front tires in a front-wheel drive car. The front tires are scrubbing against the ground a little bit. They're going a little bit faster than the rears. And if you're able to take some load off the front tires and distribute it to the rears, you can reduce that energy loss. Now, on dry pavement, at this point, we're still, if we were to engage the rear wheels, drive the rear wheels on dry pavement, we'd still be wasting a little bit more energy turning that differential than we gained by not slipping the front tires. In the snow, we're already more fuel efficient with four-wheel drive than with two-wheel drive. So what they're working on is trying to get the energy losses in the all-wheel drive system down to the point where the energy we lose in the rear diff is less than what we gain by not letting the front tires slip. One of these days, hopefully, we'll get there.
We have car 3 all-wheel drive, i-ACTIV. Blizzaks, zero fuss and all the drama of an elementary school play. Nicely done, guys.
So I found me an MX-5, and I'm gonna go drive it.
This has been great fun, at least the parts that were inside the car. I'm Aaron Gold for AutoVitel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. There have got to be better ways to make money on the internet.